is an exhibition that came out of the research trip that I did about 2 years ago in Winnipeg, Canada. I was invited by a small yet very vibrant art organization based in Winnipeg called MAWA to go and spend about 5 or 6 days in the town and really familiarize with the local artists. They had a lot of studio visits set up for me, and I gave a little presentation about my curatorial activity, talking about my exhibitions and sort of how I approach my curating. I started to kind of see a red thread that was interesting to me, which was really about the connection between the artist and the landscape. And I started thinking about artists who I had met here in Miami, some I had worked with, some I had just done studio visits. And I thought, well, wouldn't it be interesting to connect with artists in Miami whose work also is somehow connected to the landscape or has been inspired by nature, and see how these artists that are immersed in these very different landscapes deal with the nature around them.
It's saying something about this interaction, how these artists from Canada and artists from Miami come up with some kind of connection that it has been through nature. And I think that is very self-explanatory. I don't think that you need to know really a lot of contemporary art. You have drawings, you have some 3D items and smaller sculptures, you have video. So I think that you easily see this contrast between one landscape and the other, and also the kind of materials used, sometimes very, very connected with the nature.
The one work that really triggered the whole exhibition was actually a series of sculptures which are here in the Richard Schott Gallery by Winnipeg-based artist Diana Thornycroft. And Diana has been mostly working with photography, but when we met, she had just started working on a series of sculptures. And they're essentially plastic horses, they're little plastic toys that she buys, and then she heats them in the oven, and once she said she just forgot about it, and so she ended up leaving the horse for too long and it started melting. So, you know, one of the legs went down, and so she looked at this beautiful horse that she loved the way it came and looked at it in this deformation, and I fell in love with them. I thought, you know, they were strong, they were powerful, they were beautiful, they were eerie and grotesque, and it was kind of like all these elements in, you know, in one sculpture. I was interested to create dialogues right between Miami and Winnipeg, as I said. So, for example, I had met this Miami-based artist named Andrew Nygan, and I saw he had some beautiful sculpture of horses from Carousel. And so I invited him to participate and create a beautiful installation 924. And then there was a Canadian artist who was working with bees and placing scans on beehives. So the bees are actually becoming part of the art making process. And then last year I had seen Antonia Wright's video, stunning video bee at her Solo Spinello project, where she does Tai Chi moves with literally a swarm of bees on her.
At the time, our government was always very quick to go to war, and when we feel threatened, we always act aggressively. So I was supposed to talk to that, how just because we feel threatened doesn't mean we always have to act violently. So for the bees, it was, if they didn't harm me, if I didn't harm them, they would not harm me.
Well, it's pretty unique, really, because I mean, I think that the most important thing is that the public, the general public, have access to the creative process of the artist. They get to know how the artist develop a work if they come 1 week and then they come in a month later, let's say. Then they get to see what the artist has been doing. This is something very exciting for the general public, and especially in this location where the high amount of visitors, usually they are not so familiar with contemporary art. So for them it's really a unique experience. First, get to see an exhibition in contemporary art where usually it's thought-provoking and we are trying to shake the crowds. And then we get to see also the environment where an artist is creating their work. Stay tuned for the new changes and the future ahead of the Art Center. And again, all the people and all the crowd is welcome to the 924 building here in Lincoln Road. We are not leaving Lincoln Road, and we are not going to stop providing and giving programs and supporting the artists and the art here in Miami.